How to become a vampire in ESO. It doesn't matter if you watch too much Twilight or if you're just a fan of vampires like me. In this video, I will help you to get doom into never-ending pain and bloodlust. So with that said, how do I become a vampire now? Well, you need to get bitten by one, obviously. And this is possible if you just ask nicely in chat for a bite or maybe in a guild, so another vampire player can change you into a creature of the night, or you get the vampire curse from an NPC.
But which NPC?
I can hear the voices in my head asking. Well, the NPC is called Ludfiend and spawns only at night in these specific locations I will show you right now. But what if you don't want to look for some blood fiends to get bitten? Well then, as I said, you could ask a player. And when you found someone that wants to suck your precious blood out of you, you need to meet your new vampire friend at one of these locations. Because only there you can get your bite. And these locations are not that hard to find because there's literally like a really big stone altar, so I think you should find them. After you got bitten, you should see a quest in front of you on the stone altar. Just accept the quest, go through the portal and absolve it. After that, you are officially a vampire. Congratulations! To see a new skill line you just got, you just need to press K on PC and then look under the topic World. There you should see your new vampire skill line. And what the skills do and what I recommend to use them for comes right now. The first ability you will get is Eviscerate. Eviscerate is a Magicka-based spammable ability that deals up to 33% more damage based on your missing health. After you level this ability a bit, you can morphus in Arterial Burst or Blood for Blood. Let's stay first by Arterial Burst. That was not intended. And this ability gives you a 100% crit chance if you are under 50% of health. Other morph, now Blood for Blood costs health and it deals up to 60% more damage based on your missing health instead of the previous 33%. And one really big drawback is that you can't get healed by allies or people in your group for 5 seconds after using this ability. The second ability is Blood Frenzy. Blood Frenzy is an ability that costs 1804 health every second, but boosts your weapon and spell damage by 630. Also, good to know, the health costs increase by 20% every second you have this active. So if you want to use it, you need to toggle it on. And if you don't want to use it anymore, you need to toggle it off. And if you don't do that, you probably will die. So keep that in mind, please. The first morph is Sated Fury, and with that you get 30% of your total health cost as heal back to you after you toggle the ability off again. The second morph is Simmering Frenzy. With that, the bonus of the weapon and spell damage gets increased by 10% every second this stays on. I would recommend this ability for healers, to be honest, because healers can out heal this for a bit and can boost their spell damage, which is also important for healing, even further. The third ability is Vampiric Drain. This ability is, in my opinion, a kind of a meme ability because the damage you do does not scale. You always do the same damage and you get 23% of your missing health back every second for 3 seconds. The first morph for that is called Accelerating Drain, and this gives you also some ultimate if you use this ability. The second morph is a Drain Vigor, and this restores a portion of your missing stamina, but only by, I think, 5% or something. And I'm really honest, I don't recommend this ability. Maybe you find something where this is very useful, but honestly, I don't think it's pretty good. The fourth ability is called Mesmerize. Mesmerize is a stun that stuns enemies for 5 seconds if they are in front of you and they need to face in your direction. What is also be important, the stun cannot be blocked. The first morph is Stupefy, and this morph gives you the ability that the enemies you just stunned are snared for 50% for 5 seconds after the stun ended. The second morph is Hypnosis, and in my opinion the better one, because you stun all enemies around you and they need to face in your direction. If you are a Magicka damage dealer that plays Vampire and PvP, or you struggle maybe in some PvE encounters and you want a stun, this thing is pretty cool, and it also looks really awesome in my opinion. I love the look of the ability. The fifth ability is Mist Form. With Mist Form, you transform into a bloody bat swarm and you take 75% less damage as long as you maintain in this form. But it costs Magicka every second. The first morph is Blood Mist. With Blood Mist, you deal damage to all enemies around you and you heal for the damage you caused. Pretty simple. The second morph is Elusive Mist. With that form, your movement speed is 30% higher. If you are in PvE, I would recommend Blood Mist if you want to play this ability, and if you are in PvP, I would recommend Elusive Mist. And something that is true for all morphs or the base ability is that when you activate it, you remove all snares and you can't be snared while you're in this ability, but your stamina, magicka and health recovery is stopped while you're in it. And the ultimate for the vampire skill line is Blood Scion. With Blood Scion, you transform yourself into a big vampire lord. You remember that if you played Skyrim. And you add yourself 10,000 health, magicka and stamina. And on top of that, 15% of the damage you deal comes back to you as healing. When you level this ability up, you can decide between Perfect Scion and Swarming Scion. With Perfect Scion, you ascend into vampire stage 5 and you lose all your debuffs you have with the, for example, the health recovering debuff or the extra flame damage debuff. Other morph, Swarming Scion, gives you an additional AoE that is completely around you that deals 2775 magic damage every second. I personally prefer the Swarming Scion because you do damage around you, and if you play PvE, your DPS gets higher, and if you play PvP, everyone will panic because that's a shit ton of damage and they'll try to run away. So I would prefer that, but if you want to play Perfect Scion, you can do that, and I think maybe there are also builds out there that Perfect Scion is better in. Now we take a closer look at the passive abilities of the vampire skill line. The first ability allows you to drink blood from enemy or friendly NPCs so you can increase your vampire stage to get a nice buff for vampire ability cost reduction, but gives you also 3 major debuffs. These are health recovery reduction, more flame damage taken, and an increased regular ability cost. That's like every other ability than the vampire ones. The second passive is Dark Stalker, and with that you ignore the movement speed penalty in sneak by 25% at stage 1 and at stage 2 by 50%. This is pretty nice if you are playing a Nightblade, because this also applies to your invisibility cloak. The third passive is called Strike from the Shadows, and this increases your weapon and spell damage if you leave sneak or invisibility or your mist form, but only if you are at Vampire Stage 2. The fourth passive is Undeath. With that passive, you reduce your damage taken by up to 15% at Stage 1, and at Stage 2, you get up to 30% damage reduction based on your missing health. But this is only available if your Vampire Stage is on Breed. The next passive is called Blood Ritual. With that passive, you are allowed to transform transform another player into a vampire, but only once every 7 days. And the last passive is unnatural movement, and when you are at vampire stage 4, the cost of sprint is reduced by 25%, and if you sprint longer than 6 seconds, you are invisible. This can also be leveled to 2 stages, so you get, instead of 25%, 50% reduction on your sprint cost. And that is everything you need to know if you want to be a vampire in ESO. But maybe I missed something. And if that is the case, then please put that in the comments down below. Or if something changed and I did not notice it, then please correct me. Let me also know in the comments for which topic in ESO you want to see the next video. And if you want to watch some videos right now, then you can click at the info card to see the playlist for some more ESO videos. And also, if you don't want to miss anything in the future, because I also do other MMORPG content, then you can click subscribe if you want to. I thank you all for watching. I wish you all an awesome day. I hope that you are happy, because that is the most important thing. And leb wohl!